In this video, we'll talk about how to configure port security in Packet Tracer. For our configuration, we'll use the basic topology on the screen. As you can see, there's a switch and there are three hubs connected to this switch. And there's also a separate PC connected to the switch. In each part of this topology, you'll see a different violation mechanism. Let's start to configure port security on the switch. We'll start with the fastnet 01. For this example, we'll use the MAC address of the PC. So I will allow only this MAC address. In this example, we configured port security for a static MAC address. We set to the router that only allow this MAC address, and if there is another connection occurs, then shut down the port. And let's save this config. Let's check the port security status. As you can see, fastnet 01 is with maximum address 1, and there is also one address, and the security action is shut down. There is no violation. And now let's change the connection to the PC1. As you know, it's a different MAC address. It has a different MAC address. Now, switch don't know the MAC address of PC1. Let's explore here. The switch has the MAC address of PC0, the previous one. To let the switch learn PC's MAC address, let's ping action. And firstly, we need to configure the PC's IP address. By the way, let's configure all of the IP addresses for PCs. Okay, as you can see, after a while our interface go down. And let's check this action in the switch. You can see. And when we say show port security, you'll see that security violation count is 1. Let's configure fast Ethernet 0, 2 and fast Ethernet 3 for the other violation types, restrict and protect. Always we need to configure the ports as a access port. Here we'll say maximum 1 address. And violation type this time we'll use protect. With protect there is no logging, in restriction there is logging. Yes. Here we can also configure the ccna addresses. It is dynamic learning. As you can see, there's no security violation now, because in port security, in the protection, there's no logging. And now let's configure the other violation restriction. Let's check the port security status. As you can see, the fast Ethernet 03 is configured as restrict mode. And let's the ping action. As you can see, the restriction security violation count is increasing when we say here. As you can see, the port security is enabled and the port status is secure up and violation mode is restrict. And the evaluation count is 3. We can see our configuration here also for interface fast Ethernet 03. Here we say router that port security is open for this port and MAC address learning is sticky, it's a dynamic version, it's not static. and the violation choices is restrict, and in restrict mode, as you can see, the logging is on. Here you can see the dynamically learned MAC address here. And lastly, let's compare fast ethernet 04 for the right side of this topology. Here I will use the violation mode shutdown, and we will restrict the port with 2 MAC address, and it they will be sticky. When we connect the other PC, it will go to the error disable mode. For this, I will delete this connection, and then let's configure our switch. Let's do a ping action. And, here, when we say show port security. As you can see, Fast Ethernet 04 has a maximum 2 MAC address, and it has also 2 MAC address, so there is no security violation, and our port is up here. And let's see our running config. As you can see, our MAC addresses are here. Let's verify from the PC configuration. Yes. And the second one. Yes. And now let's connect our PC. And from the PC, let's ping some places. This will make the switch learn the PC's MAC address, and it will go to the shutdown mode. Yes, as you can see, after ping, switch learned the new MAC address, and it was restricted with 2 MAC addresses, so it shut down the port. And when we check this on the switch, as you can see, Fast Ethernet 04 has one security violation, and the port is shut down. In this video, I showed you how to configure port security in Packet Tracer.